Ladies and gentlemen, this battle is for women in arms of the Cruiserweight Division, brought to you courtesy of Friend of Women Promotions in association with Mami Boxing. The referee for this contest is Andy Brook, your timekeeper, Danny Drennan. Introducing first, boxing out of your blue collar, wears the white and blue shorts, is a weight 13 stone, 5 pounds and 12 ounces. Tonight he takes part in his 19th professional contest from Derby, Nathan Juno. And the boys in costume, boxing out of your red corner. He wears the silver and black shorts, official weight 12 stone, 11 pounds and 14 ounces. He brings an undefeated professional record, 3 victories and 1 draw, 1 win coming by way of knockout. From Rochdale, James Albert! For 3 minutes.
Second up, Ramon. your heads in. Watch your heads close.
Don't get in close, James.
Second down, round three.
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, after four rounds of action, your referee Andy Brooks scores a contest 39 points to 37. Your winner, James!
picked up a lot in that fight there as well, weren't they? I mean, you got caught in the first round, you shown heart to come back. Every time you got caught, you came back. It was a really good fight.
Thank you, yeah.
Really good fight.
Tough lad. Big, strong lad, honestly, lad. Couldn't move him like a brick, honestly.
Yeah, so, yeah. How do you assess it, Mick, as a coach? I mean, I said that, you know, improvements.
He has, yeah, because, like, you know, James's fights, he loves the war, James, but he's better than that, he can box. And that's what we wanted to do, because tonight, if he would have gone in doing his other stuff, we could have won, it might have been a different result, because we knew this kid could bang. And like, James has gone up a couple of pounds as well, he's gone to cruiserweight, only because, unfortunately, his other opponent had to pull out, so Kevin fair play to Kevin, he got him at the last minute, or else James would have been fighting. Yeah. So we know what the kid's doing, and he has knocked three or four kids out himself.
Because a few upsets.
Tough lad.
Yeah.
Like I said, my bottle, he did it waiting first round when he got the four, please.
I
could hear it.
How did you feel yourself in there, and you know, I'm not coming over that?
Started slow. I think after I was getting bollocked every time I came back to the corner, but every time.
Can I just interrupt? What it is, to be honest with you, he's been sparring Clay Murray. Michael Murray's brilliant kid, he'll be a future, he'll be a good one. James has been up, but we need different sparring, and because James works so hard at his job, he has to keep working because he's got children and that. We find it hard sparring at night times because people spar during the day. We've been offered loads, go down to Phoenix Jam, Alex Matvienko's, but we can't during the day, so it's just unfortunate for him at the moment.
But we got through
him. We want to get through, and again, your box fucking, sorry for swearing, your box brilliant, mate. Everything you were told.
You worked for.
Yeah, definitely.
Talk us through it, you know, what do you take out of there? I mean, you've come out of there, you feel you've improving, you say it's your
I'm
fifth
improving,
fight.
Yeah, I can, yeah, from my first fight to this fight, I'm definitely improving. But if they fought the guy who was in the first fight, he'd have beaten me, hands down, do you know what I mean? I felt his extra weight, that was a cert, do you know. I could possibly use the jab a lot more, you know, not leaning into shots and, you know, leaving my head hanging, but you learn. I'm learning on the job, aren't I?
Yeah.
So.
But like I say, I'm not just saying it, but we're just limited with sparring, aren't we? So you know yourself, you can do much pad work as you want. You can be best padman or what, but he doesn't set punches. The pads don't set punches back and move around. So
I've still got time. Yeah,
you've got plenty of time. Yeah. You're still learning.
I remember an interview you did with us a while back, and you said, you know, if a central area title would be your world title, you know, and I thought it was a very humble thing to say. You also said, time's not on my side, but you know, you're looking back on
I'm
that now,
you're right direction.
You are, yeah. So I mean, it's a realistic target, so it's nice
it's
thing to say.
Still my world title, competing for every title. You know, I'm 37, I'm getting younger. You know, I'm training my ass off. You're older, it's harder to. Do you know, to get yourself on that road running and in that gym, but I'm
you
still
do
doing
time,
it.
Though. I don't have to tell you about it, you do it on your own back. Yeah. In fact, I have to tell him to stop training, he trains too hard.
That's still my target, I know it will be. So I know my level in boxing. You know, it is what it is. So.
I think, well, you made good improvements there, and you've shown a lot of character to come through, you know, the early, your legs stiffened up a little bit, you put it back straight back on him, and you know, it's a tricky opponent, you've done well, so
thank
I think you can
very
be
much.
Very
thank
pleased
you.
With that. Thank What's you. Next, James? Nice rest,
something
to eat,
off.
And then.
Something to eat, and we'll have a week off, then I'll swallow it straight back out.
Yeah, you've got to see him back out, Mick. That's Cook's
it.
Boss.
Yeah,
thank you very much.
Back in there. Yeah. Okay, congratulations, guys.
Thank you.